On Tuesday, anti-corruption demonstrators who defied security advice were countered by police forces and arrested.
Stop corruption! Stop!
Stop corruption! Stop! Stop corruption!
In a statement released by the Presidential Press Unit this morning, the President, Yoweri Museveni, hailed security and armed forces for foiling the planned protests in the city. In the statement, Museveni revealed what he termed the two bad elements in the demonstrations. These were funding from foreign sources, which are always meddling in internal affairs to destabilize Africa, and bad things that had been planned by the organizers. Museveni stated that he remains the custodian in the fight against corruption and would have gladly joined the protesters if they had been peaceful and without ill motives. During last week's presidential address, Museveni warned planners of the demonstrations to halt the activity, a call they did not heed. The president said foiling the demonstrations was an intelligence-led operation with credible information and evidence that will shock the country during the trial of the suspects. The woman member of parliament for Masindi district, Florence Asimwa Kiki, appended the final signature on the censure motion of the four parliamentary commissioners who allegedly received a service award of 1.7 billion shillings. Addressing the media at parliament today, the movers of the motion, led by Remiaga County Member of Parliament Theodore Sachikubo, expressed gratitude to journalists for covering the censure motion.
So the fourth estate, I and my colleagues, we owe it to you. We thank you. I thank colleagues, members of parliament. And as he has said, it doesn't matter where one joins you, but it is also important that you all move together when you are fully convinced.
So Chikubo said that they have the 177 signatures required in the parliamentary rules of procedure to table the censure motion for the four embattled commissioners. So Chikubo revealed that by next week, the requisite notice bearing the names of legislators who had appended their signatures will be published. He added that those who sit to append their signatures could use this weekend.
I've been waiting for the guidance until today, to no avail. My voters in Masindi have been on my neck, wondering why I have refused to sign the censure motion.
The third National Prefects Conference 2024 was held today at Hotel Africana under the theme Drug Abuse Effect on Mental Health. The conference aims to raise awareness on the issues related to drugs and other substance abuse in schools. Anne Sebunya, the founder of Drugs Hapana Initiative, described how critical the situation had been in schools before this sensitization campaign.
By the time we started going to schools, there was a lot of lack of knowledge on drugs and substance abuse. Many had a lot of myths and misperceptions surrounding. Yes, even now they are still existing, but before it was too much.
She encouraged mental health clubs and counselors in schools, saying they play a critical role in addressing the challenge of drugs and substance abuse. Agra David Chibenge, the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, said that emphasis in the fight against drug abuse should be placed on prevention measures.
Defenses against child abuse, defenses against drug abuse must be planted within the homes. It is not in the remand homes.
He also emphasized the critical role that families play in this fight. The National Prefects Conference is an initiative that provides an information dissemination platform on drug and substance abuse to student leaders, who then pass on the information to their peers.